Good morning, sir. I'd like to briefly touch on two issues. Someone has mentioned one. Democratic leadership does not listen to us. That is accurate. If you'll allow me, I'm going to be brief because I know time is short. A bunch of us went up to New Hampshire, door knocking in Manchester for Bernie Sanders, okay? He won in New Hampshire, and we worked our tails off in Rhode Island. Bernie won in Rhode Island. And then our super delegates sold us down the river.
We had Jim Caiazzo, who led the Bernie campaign here in Rhode Island.
Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna, that's my first point. The super delegates did not listen to us and endorsed Hillary.
Another reason why I did not vote Democrat last year. I should have voted third party.
I have the floor if I can make the second point, okay? I would ask that you not make any more speeches on the Florida Senate concerning the environment, climate change. Okay? Because when I talk to your staff, Mr. Caiazzo, whoever, oh, that's a local issue, a power plant in Burrville. You've never been to Burrville, right? In 6 years or 12.
Yeah.
Okay?
Been to Burrville regularly.
Yeah, sure.
Last time was before we had an opioid. All right, let me finish. I'm going to be brief.
Yes, factually, okay? Now, this gas plant up there, right? You like gas. I found out, after being in the heating industry for 40 years, I found out that methane gas is a climate change accelerator that's worse than CO2. Yet you will not come out and take a stand against that plant? No. Our resources are at risk, our water supply in the state, and like Joe told me, oh, it's a local issue. Climate change is a global issue. So if you're not going to stand up for us, please don't get on the Florida Senate, you know, because we know, that's not factual. What you say and what you do are two different things. Take a big time.
Okay. I hear you. For what it's worth, I have a very strong belief that when something is subject to a rule of law proceeding, like a trial, in which you have lawyers and evidence and appeal to courts, that that's not a really good place for political pressure to be brought to bear. If there was a trial going on in the United States District Court, it would not be right for me to be walking up and down outside trying to influence that trial, just as it is wrong for President Trump and his crowd to be, if he is, and I think he is, trying to influence the grand jurors and trying to influence the public about the FBI investigation. When there is a rule of law proceeding that is subject to judicial review, that is kind of sacrosanct. The issue of the Invenergy plant is before the Energy Facility Siting Board in a rule of law proceeding that will be reviewed by courts, that requires evidence under oath, where people are represented by lawyers. And whatever my personal views may be about how that state effort should turn out, it is a contested case, it is a rule of law proceeding, and I think how many times have we had this conversation?
Not enough.
Well, okay. Like, at least 20.
Not enough. Mr. Whitehouse.
We know where we stand
on
this.
Do you know that line, that gas line is coming from Canada? Right down the eastern seaboard, spewing the methane that he talks about. The fracking out west is ruining the water supply that now Invenergy wants to use our energy, our water supply here in Scituate.
Yeah.
Come on,
and who,
Sheldon,
who,
you are our champion.
Who led the charge to get the fracking properly quantified at EPA, so we knew those numbers and could
how much
fix
they're
that
leaking,
problem.
You mean?
Both leaking and fracking. Both.
Every 35 miles, they're
going
to have a compressor
That's
station
me.
From Canada down to Florida.
I yeah. think they
Look,
are.
I apologize That's, that I'm not going to agree with
I'm
you
sorry.
About the Invenergy plan.
I'm sorry. But
and
this
it's not
is
about
not
the
only Invenergy
plan. It's about, for me, that if this were a trial, and I see this as like a trial, I actually used to do those cases. I was the lawyer for the state in those administrative cases. So I know this process. I trust the people involved. I
we
trust Meg Curran.
The process
I trust
is
Meg
corrupt.
Curran. She was the U.S. attorney after me. She's an honorable woman. I have no problem with her. I trust Janet Coit, who is our DEM director, and who is the other decider.
One of
and I trust Michael Bibier's whose person, who was the director of planning, is the third person sitting on that.
No.
And if we and if there's disagreement about whether that was done fairly, the Supreme Court will take it up. So, you know, we can agree or disagree about this. But I think once things get into that rule of law world, it is really dangerous for politicians to be playing around in that. And I apologize that we disagree on this. We've had these conversations over and over again, as you know. But don't think that my effort to solve this problem in Washington is anything less than sincere. There is nobody who works harder on this issue than it.
I'm in the middle of nowhere. You know, my life is FaceTime. Happy birthday.